Everyone, welcome back to another scrapbook layout video. Today I am making another layout using the Down on the Farm collection. Actually, this one will probably go up. No, I'll put the other one up first, probably. Anyways, doesn't really matter, does it? So, again, I've had this collection for a long time. This is a 2018 collection, and I have had a lot of pictures. I have a stack that I know I want to try to use with this collection. So I decided to pull it out because I was inspired to use it. So I think I've been trying to use things lately that haven't been inspiring me. I have recorded some videos. I haven't done a voiceover for them or anything yet because I wasn't really inspired, but I think I still will, just to kind of show you guys that that happens sometimes. So I am following a sketch. I don't remember the sketch. It is by Scrapbook Generation. I'm going to alter it a little bit again because my photos were a little bit different. I am scrapbooking some photos of my daughter, and this was her way back in, I don't know, second grade-ish time, second, third grade, maybe first, when she was part of Girl Scouts and they went for a ride, like a horse ride. They got to go to a barn and ride some horses. So this was definitely a perfect collection. She was also wearing a blue sweatshirt, which you will see here in a few minutes. So that is going to coordinate really well. Going to be honest, for a little while, I didn't really care for the way this sketch was going. It seemed like it had a lot of the pattern paper on the left-hand side and not anything really on the right-hand side. But once I added my journaling in the end, I really ended up liking this layout. It's, again, kind of another different one for me. I'm trying to look for sketches that I've never used before when I'm picking out my sketches and trying to, you know, change it up a little bit instead of using the same sketches. So I already have my photos pre-cut to the sizes. And again, I think I have more photos than what her sketch called for. And a couple of them I didn't want to cut down any further. You guys will be proud of me because I did go through, I think I had like 19 photos of this event, but I went through and really narrowed it down, knowing that a lot of the photos were, you know, from pre-digital times. So I guess they were still digital, but you know, before I was really better at picking out which photos, and I still have a ton of them, but I got rid of the ones where she's not looking directly at the camera or it's just not the best face, things like that. So and I'm glad that I did it that way because I feel like the page turned out better than if I would have tried to add in all those photos, even the ones that weren't all that great. So I was happy about that. This sketch called for that strip, and you can see I knew that I only had like one of each of these pattern papers. So instead of using an entire strip right there, which I had originally cut it down, not even thinking that I could just cut two small pieces. So I went ahead and just cut off two little strips to make it look like there's, you know, paper going behind the whole thing. And I'm glad I did because I am going to use that strip of blue on other layouts. It was just a really good blue color. I'm adding this here. So for the most part, I'm following the sketch to this point. I'm adding this actually in the wrong spot. So on the sketch, she has this kind of, it's a stripe strip that she has, but I figured I wanted to just use the banners. There was no stripes actually in this Doodlebug collection. I'm kind of surprised about that, but there was other ones. So other random kind of rather unique designs is what I was trying to say. So I think that's why there was no stripes, but I am going to realize that in a little while, and I am going to move those two green pieces to be along the brown edges, which is where they were supposed to be. On her sketch as well, she also didn't have four photos here. She had three photos and then like either a journaling block or a title block. And so I knew I could put my journaling or my title somewhere else. So I wasn't really that worried about it. So I put the four photos there because, like I said, I had more and wanted to get them used up more. And here's where I realized that I should have added these little green pieces to the brown piece of paper, not the blue one. And it does look a little silly there, but by the time I'm done with the layout, you don't even notice. I probably could have just left them off and it would have been all the same. Now I do have, I think, three or four smaller photos that need a little bit of a matte. And one of the things that Allison Davis has in her sketches quite a bit is Polaroid-like mattes, looking mattes. And I really like that she does that. I was just trying to find a good pattern here. I didn't want to go with the blue. I felt like there was already a lot of blue in the layout, and between my daughter's sweatshirt and that blue kind of box there, I wanted to add in kind of more colors over here to the side, knowing that I wanted to add more colors around the layout itself. And I had that floral piece already down, and so that was already adding in more colors. So just trying to add more colors around. So on the back of the blue was this really cool kind of plaidish color, and that was exactly what I was looking for. So that went really perfectly. I'm not gluing it down yet because I wasn't exactly sure how I felt about that picture. So I plan on coming back to that area, and I'm going to work on the right-hand page. Now I'm going to line them up, and this is where I change up. I can't remember what she had, but she had, I believe, 2 4x6 vertical photos and then some photos below that. And I'm going to end up changing the size of the photos that go below, and I'm just going to use this one that I've just cut. And I'm just trying to get it to fit in the size of the area. It's not, I can't remember. It's not like an exact 3.5 by 5 or anything like that. It's just some random size that I cut to fit there to work with all my photos. Like I said, this kind of at this point, I was not too crazy about this layout. I also knew I wanted to kind of bring over more of that plaid color now that I used it on the left-hand side. And so I decided to cut this photo down just another hair and add it on a mat too. And that also helps break up the fact, like all the cluster of photos. So where these photos are all clustered together, a lot of times you can do different things, but I decided to just mat it with that plaid. So that brought that color over as well. And then I think I have these two last little photos. I'm trying to decide if I needed them or not. And I wanted to keep them. She's like brushing the horse. One of them, she's brushing the horse, like I said. And the other one, I can't remember, but I had dwindled this down. How many is on there? 4, 4, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 from 19, I believe there was 19. So I felt like I had dwindled it down as much as I wanted to. And there was even one more picture that I was really, I don't know, it was that one or one of these other ones I'd already put on the layouts. And it was a hard decision. But you know what? I'm glad that I chose the ones that I did. And I feel like I got enough of the story and the happiness of her. She really enjoyed it. She wasn't one of those little girls that, "Mom, can I have a pony? Mom, I want a pony," or anything like that, or really played with horses more than anything else. It wasn't anything like that for her, but she really enjoyed riding these horses this day. She was almost more towards being more of a pony girl afterwards. So now I'm going to play around with the embellishments. I have not yet, again, glued down any of those smaller photos. I just wasn't exactly sure how I wanted them. I knew I wanted to use this horse doodle pop. I only have the horse in the barn. I don't always buy the doodle pops unless I'm just absolutely in love with the collection, but I did buy the horse knowing I had. Because these pictures are a lot older than this collection. So when I bought this collection, I knew I had these pictures. So I'm just trying to play around. I liked the blue ribbon because that kind of, could go along with horses like winning the race or things like that. And it really, brought in more of the blue. Oh, I actually really like that horse there by the ribbon. I didn't at the time, but looking at it here on the video, I kind of wish I would have left it there. But I decided to try to put him down below. And there's also, you can see here there's more horse stickers. And when I put my die cuts together, if you're new to my channel, I will just mention really quick what I do with my die cuts that come in the ephemera packs is I kind of separate them usually by different reasons. It's usually color, theme, things like that. And then I put a little bit of removable adhesive on the back, and then I put them on page protectors with just a piece of typewriter paper inside them. The typewriter paper is just there to make it easier to see the die cuts. And so this one, I took the time to put like all the cow sticker or die cuts and cow sayings. There was like sayings to go along with the cows. You can see down in the bottom one that says you're extra special. So it's next to all the chicken and eggs. So I had all the horse pieces together. I've used since used this collection a little more, and they're not as as organized as they were, but I don't mind. One thing I've realized since doing this, though, is I probably won't purchase doodle bugs. Excuse me. This was like when they first started coming out with their like the sayings pack. They have an ephemera pack that's usually more like elements like stickers or like people or like the cows or the horses. And then they also come out with a pack that's more words and sayings and titles. And I always thought that I would use those titles quite a bit, but after using this collection and the birthday collection, I realize again, I've mentioned this in a few videos, and maybe I'll just do a separate video and kind of talk about my thinking so you guys can know a little more about my thinking. But even with Doodlebug, I'm kind of to the point where I'm not going to order the packs anymore because I don't really care for this sticker sheet here. I feel like they've done this sticker sheet over and over, and I've mentioned that. But I won't buy the saying pack anymore. And I like that they have that saying pack because there's a lot of sayings that are really geared towards card making, which is why I think they do that. And I think that's great. Like this, hey there sticker, which I'm actually going to use on this layout. There's some that'll work for both, and then there's some that don't work so well for both. And the ones that don't work so well for both, I didn't even put on these sheets because they are definitely more card or sending to somebody sayings. I'll talk about that in another video, though. I'll kind of maybe my next Doodlebug or order, I'll take out the new versus the old and show you my thinking to try to save. You guys know I'm trying to buy a little better, with my whole Spend Less, Scrap More series and everything like that too. So here's a one of these. Now things like this is really cute that comes with the die cut in that word pack. So I will miss these, but it's not the end of the world. But there is sayings like the hey there and that nay. So I'm gonna make a little cluster of them, but I don't know. Sometimes I just find them harder to use and kind of don't end up always using them. So a lot of them sometimes are repetitive too. They're just in different shapes. So we will see. Anyways, back to the layout. I decided to put the horses. There was two horses, so I put them down below together. And then I added that little pony up on the right-hand side. I glued my photos down. So the photo on the very left, the small one is at an angle. So the photos on the very right, I put at an angle as well. And I'm sorry for the lighting. I thought I had my lighting fixed so that there wouldn't be a glare on my photos anymore, but I don't know why, because it was really good for a while. So maybe I'll have to change that again. But I'm also trying to add the color red around. There was a few places where there was red. So I'm playing around with, there's a red heart in the middle top cluster. There, I added the red heart to the ribbon. I thought that was kind of sweet there. So I tried to add this third red heart. I do finally find a place for it, I believe, but I'm going to play around with it quite a bit. And this is definitely the point where I didn't like the layout. I just felt like it was, I don't know. I didn't like the horse up there on the top right, but I wanted to use some of these horses. That's why I got this collection. Oh, I added a heart over there. I guess it wasn't red. Then I added this barn, this epoxy shaped barn. And to be honest, I really end up not liking much of this layout until I finish with my journaling. And you won't see me do the journaling, but you'll see the layout in the end with the journaling. And I really like it after I do the journaling. I add a little bit more. It just kind of fills in that bottom right area, which I think is what I was being thrown off by, was that area being kind of empty. I added some of these little flies all around because they are just really stinking cute. And I didn't know this collection had the little flies and their little stickers. So I just thought that was really cute. And then I'm going to take out these Doodlebug stickers and I'm going to make the title horse riding. So it's that also helps really well with the layout as well. It kind of adds a little something more. And since it's such a longer title, it really fills in that space. And I think I actually ended up having all those letters, thankfully. I think I'm getting low on, nope, it's not the E's. It's one of the letters. Oh, I think it was O's. I think I used my last O, so I'll have to remember that. But I definitely hope that Doodlebug, they recently came out with a font that they made into a die cut, like metal dies. So I told them, I suggested on their Facebook page that they do more, because I do love the fonts that they use. But again, I'd rather just buy the dies. And up there with the letters, I'm not worried that through the H, you can see some of the white and there's trap space and all that up there. I'm not worrying about any of that. And it doesn't bother me. Sometimes it would bother me, but just to show you, you don't always have to worry about that because the page is still really cute in the end. So I think that's about it. Other than I said I added my journaling, I did add some flowers, some of those epoxy flowers around just to kind of spread more colors around the page. And other than that, I added my date, I believe, next to the journaling. So here is a couple close-up photos. Oh, and the worm. You might see the worm. And I added some enamel dots around a few parts of the page too. So here is the full page. I hope you guys like this layout. I really love the end result. And thank you for joining me again. See you guys next time. Bye.